Welcome to Good Shepherd. If you are visiting, we are so glad that you're here with us today. And you will find a visitor card that looks like this that's in the pew right in front of you. Or if you're watching online, you can see that there is a visitor card that is online as well. It would be great if you take just a moment to fill this out, and then we can pray for you in the weeks to come. Our service is completely contained within the bulletin. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. God, the protector of all who trust in you, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, increase and multiply upon us your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide, we may so pass through things temporal that we lose not the things eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Reading from 2 Kings. A man came from Baal-shalishah, bringing food from the first fruits to the man of God, 20 loaves of barley and fresh ears of grain in his sack. Elisha said, "Give it to the people and let them eat." But his servant said, "How can I set this before 100 people?" So he repeated, "Give it to the people and let them eat. For thus says the Lord, they shall eat and have some left." He set it before them, they ate and they had some left, according to the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord. Let us say together the psalm by half verse. All your works praise you, O Lord. They make known the glory of your kingdom,
and speak of your power,
that the peoples may know of your power,
and the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom.
Your kingdom endures forever.
The Lord is faithful in all his words. The Lord upholds all those who fall. The eyes of all wait upon you, O Lord. You open wide your hand. The Lord is righteous in all his ways. The Lord is near to those who call upon him.
Reading from Ephesians. I bow my knees before the Father, for whom every family in heaven and earth takes its name. I pray that, according to the riches of his glory, he may grant that you may be strengthened in your inner being with power through his Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, as you are being rooted and grounded in love. I pray that you may have the power to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who by the power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than all we can ask or imagine, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus, to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus went to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, also called the Sea of Tiberias. A large crowd kept following him because they saw signs that he was doing for the sick. Jesus went up the mountain and sat there with his disciples. Now the Passover, the festival of the Jews, was near. When he looked up and saw a large crowd coming toward him, Jesus said to Philip, "Where are we to buy bread for all of these people to eat?" He said this to test him, for he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 6 months' wages would not buy enough bread for each of them to get a little." One of the disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are they among so many people?" Jesus said, "Make the people sit down." Now there was a great deal of grass in this place, so they sat down, about 5,000 in all. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who were seated. So also the fish, as much as they wanted. When they were satisfied, he told the disciples, "Gather up the fragments left over so that nothing may be lost." So they gathered them up, and from the fragments of the 5 barley loaves left by those who had eaten, they filled 12 baskets. When the people saw the sign that he had done, they began to say, "This is indeed the prophet who has come into the world." When Jesus realized that they were about to come and take him by force to be king, he withdrew again to the mountain by himself. When evening came, his disciples went down to the sea, got into the boat, and started across the sea to Capernaum. It was now dark, and Jesus had not yet come to them. The sea became rough because a strong wind was blowing. When they had rowed about 3 or 4 miles, they saw Jesus walking on the sea and coming near the boat, and they were terrified. But he said to them, "It is I, do not be afraid." Then they wanted to take him into the boat, and immediately the boat reached the land toward which they were going. The Gospel of the Lord. So in this gospel reading from John, how many miracles do we see? Well, we certainly see the feeding of the 5,000, and certainly there is Jesus walking on the water. But when I look at this gospel reading, for me, it's a little bit like one of those children's book illustrations. You know, the ones where the children's book is, the illustration is very, very detailed. And then you have to find little things that are hidden in that detailed drawing. Like, can you find the palm tree, or the bicycle, or 5 boxes, or 2 stars? And so you and your grandchild or your child sit down and go through that and try to find all the little things hidden in that very detailed drawing. Well, for me, this gospel lesson is a little bit like one of those very detailed drawings, and we are asked to see and find all of the miracles in this complex illustration. So let's take a look at it and see how many miracles we can find. So to begin with, 5,000 people show up to see Jesus. Can you imagine if 500 came through those doors this morning? Now that would be something. That's a miracle. And then Jesus made up his mind to do something, is what it says. He'd already made up his mind what he was going to do with regard to all these folks. And some of us might jump to the conclusion, well, he made up his mind he was going to feed them and he was going to do the miracle of the loaves and the fishes. And he already knew all that and that was going to happen. I think what he made up his mind to do is to keep this gathered group, this community that had formed, to keep them together. The disciples' suggestion is, send them off, you know, we couldn't feed them with a year's worth of wages. Send them off to do whatever they're going to do, and maybe they'll come back. So if 500 came through the door, would we just send them off because we don't have enough bulletins? No! We would share. And so that is what Jesus has in mind. That is this next miracle, is that Jesus is keeping this community together. Now, there may be other miracles that you can find in here, and I invite you to look at them. But those are a couple of them with the feeding part. Now, what about the walking on water? Certainly, that is a miracle in and of itself. But there are some other miracles, I think, that are part of that as well, that we don't see as readily because of the way it's translated. So Jesus is striding across the water, and there's the rough seas, and the disciples, it says, are terrified. I think the proper word is they were freaking out, for sure. And the reality of it is that Jesus says, in the translation, says, "It is I," which is kind of a weird way to put it. What he actually said in the ancient Greek is, "I am," which is how God refers to God's self in the Old Testament. In other words, Jesus walks up to the side of the boat and says, "I am," and then in parens, "God." Then it says, they wanted to take him into the boat. Now, that's kind of a weird way to put it, too. And I think the translators really worked hard to make this flow as a story, but literally what it says is they received him. And that's really important in the Gospel of John because that term received is sprinkled throughout the entire Gospel. And when we see the word received in the Gospel of John, what that actually means is that they believed that Jesus was the Son of God. And so when they say they wanted to take him in the boat, it means that they received him. They believed that this is the Son of God, and they believed. Well, if we all were to take a look at this complex illustration and then keep finding miracles, I assure you there are more miracles that can be found. In fact, in the Bible study class that we had at 9 o'clock, several people found miracles that I hadn't seen. But I was like, wow, there it is. I missed that one. Thank you. It takes all of our eyes to see that. This gospel reading is crammed, literally crammed, wall to wall with miracles. And I have a feeling that this is often the case in our respective lives as well. That our lives are crammed with miracles, but because of all the details and the distractions and the things that are going on in our appointments and our calendars, we just seem to miss seeing those miracles. There is a stanza from a famous Victorian poet, Elizabeth Barrett Brown. She is an 1800s poet, and she wrote a poem entitled Aurora Leigh. And a stanza from that fairly long poem is as follows. Earth's crammed with heaven, and every common bush afire with God. And only he who sees takes off his shoes. The rest sit around and pluck blackberries. Think about that. The earth is crammed with heaven, and every common bush is afire with God. The miracles and God are all around us all the time. All we need to do is to look and to see. Well, if earth is crammed with heaven, and we can see that all the common bushes are afire with God, then let's take a look at some of the miracles right around us right now. We are now 2 months into meeting together in person, right here, after 14 months of being separate due to the pandemic. I'm going to chalk that up to being a miracle. And then, after this service is over today, we are going to join together for our picnic potluck, the first shared meal of this community in more than 14, actually 16 months. It's our first shared meal, and it's going to be right across the courtyard in the big hall over there. Everybody is welcome. We have tons and tons of food. We are going to be doing the miracle of multiplying sub sandwiches and salads and snickerdoodle cookies is what we are doing today. Now, you might say, well, okay, Brent, those could be minor miracles. I might give you that. But, you know, is Jesus really in that multiplication miracle mode anymore? Are there really loaves and fishes things going on out in the world today? And you might be right in saying that there aren't, but I will challenge you on that. Let me give you an example. St. Bede's Episcopal Church is located in Santa Fe, New Mexico. St. Bede's decided a year or so ago that they would take 10% of their pledges and plate offering, which is their income. They would tithe 10% and give that to outreach. In other words, it didn't go for the benefit of this church. It went to people that are outside the church. They decided that they would partner with a group, a nonprofit called RIP Medical Debt. And after a year, they had $15,000, and they paid off $1.4 million of bad medical debt. They wiped out, at that moment, all the bad medical debt in the entire state of New Mexico and part of Arizona. It was 782 households received letters that St. Bede's forgave their medical debt. RIP Medical Debt is a nonprofit that negotiates the purchase of medical debt from collection agencies and hospitals. As a rule of thumb, about a dollar will buy $100 of medical debt. Now, I've been reading about this, and 29 other Episcopal churches in the United States have done this too, including St. Michael's Episcopal Church in Lexington, Kentucky. I came from Lexington, if you don't know. And my friend, Lori Brock, is the rector of that church. Lori's church partnered with a Baptist church, a Presbyterian church, a Jewish temple, and a non-denominational church. So it almost sounds like one of those jokes where you say, a Baptist, a Presbyterian, a Jew, a non-denominational, an Episcopalian walk into a bar. Except what they did is that they pooled their money together, and they just wiped out $6.5 million in medical debt for people who were in medical debt in Alabama, Georgia, Mississippi, and Tennessee. Talk about multiplication. That is nothing short than a burning bush or a miracle that Jesus has created. One of the thank you notes that St. Michael's received from one of the persons whose medical debt was forgiven This person said, I'm blown away. I'm sitting here trying to figure out how I got so lucky. This debt has haunted me for years. I had no way to pay it and to try to live. Thank you. I am truly grateful for this. Currently, collection agencies hold $140 billion in unpaid medical bills for Americans. Currently, 18% of all Americans have some medical debt that is in collection. We are the only developed country in the world where this is the case. So, there is plenty of mission work to go around. Jesus feeds the 5,000 with just a few loaves and a few fish. Jesus walks on water and reveals, I am God. Churches pay off millions of dollars in medical debt with just a few thousand dollars. Indeed, earth crammed with heaven, and every common bush afire with God. And only he who sees takes off his shoes, and the rest pluck back blackberries. Where are the miracles? Right here, right now. Which of the bushes in the courtyard are afire with God? Where are the miracles in your life? I invite you to stand as you're able. Let us affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, deacons, especially Michael Curry, John Howard, our priests Brent Owens and Elise Gustafson, and our postulant Terry Colino.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, especially our President Joe Biden, our Governor Ron DeSantis, and our Mayor Lenny Curry.
That there may be justice and peace on earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble, especially for Chase, Brandon, Ronnie, Polly, Lawrence, Jennifer, Anne, Brian, Lisa, Nancy, Ted, Sally, Randall, Ingo, John, Glenn, Ruth, Constantine, Joyce, Gail, Art, Patricia, E.G., Judy, Dorothy, Ellen, Shirley, Jerry.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and on earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. I invite you to stand as you're able. My friends, the peace of the Lord be always with you. Welcome, and our choir is taking a much-deserved break until September, and they will start back up in September. Many thanks to Don, and we're grateful for the gift of the organ today. Many thanks for those who are serving in our worship service as well. As I mentioned in my sermon, we have a potluck luncheon that follows immediately. If you go out this door, go all the way across the courtyard, and you'll find a large hall that's called Betsy Lovett Hall. And we have subs, we have salads, we have all kinds of desserts, and there's more than enough, and we will probably have to go find a homeless shelter afterwards to donate the rest, because it will be the tables are overflowing. So some of our mission work that we're doing right now includes collecting supplies for school donations. There are several elementary schools in the area that we partner with, and so we're collecting school supplies. If you look in your bulletin, you will see a listing of all the supplies that we are collecting, and you can drop those off at the office or in the back here. Also, there's a teacher appreciation luncheon that we are helping with by supplying desserts, and we'll need desserts on August 5th, and all the details are in the bulletin. And at this time, I would like to invite Terry and George Colino to come forward. Terry is our postulant to Holy Orders, and what that means is that she is in the process to become an Episcopal priest. And she and George are moving to Austin, Texas on the 30th, and they're moving to start at Seminary of the Southwest. And that's a 3-year Master of Divinity degree. And it is not just Terry going to seminary, but Terry and George are going to seminary. We had a lovely dinner with them recently, and also the vestry voted to provide monetary support to them during the 3 years of their seminary career. So as we say goodbye, we know that scriptures are filled with stories of people who have been called to move to new places. Abraham and Sarah, Mary and Joseph, Paul and Barnabas were just a few. Filled with uncertainty about what lay ahead, these people of God could not have found their moves easy. Yet they were also filled with excitement, trusting that God was calling them and guiding them to a new place. And now you, our beloved friends, are preparing to leave us and to go to a new place, a new home, a seminary, and a new church. As part of this body of Christ over the past years, you have given yourselves to us in ways that we are truly grateful for and that we will miss tremendously. So, let us pray. Blessed are you, O God. We praise you for your constant care of those who have trusted you in ages past, who journeyed in faith to new lands of promise. We ask that you will hold Terry and George securely in your hands as they too follow your call to Seminary of the Southwest in Austin, Texas. May they take with them hearts filled with your love and grace, that those with whom they live and work may see in them the face of Jesus Christ. Bless them that they may be a blessing to others. Guide them, keep them, and protect them that they may continue to grow in grace, in spirit, and in truth through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And Terry, may the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you. George, may the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself an offering and a sacrifice to God. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of eternal life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace, and at the last day, bring us with all of your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah. The gifts of God for the people of God, holy food and drink for holy people. I invite you to stand or kneel as you're able for our post-communion prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the peace of God that passeth all understanding keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of God's Son, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.